feelings can go away. But little girl, you are here to stay. And your mommy and daddy love you so. And they're never gonna let you go.
Oh. Cayleigh Harper says wishes don't come true. Cayleigh Harper says there's no such thing as fairies. Cayleigh Harper says... Oh, that was quite loud. But I don't need to shout. Cayleigh Harper says babies wet the bed. Cayleigh Harper. I don't need to shout. I am not scared. And Cayleigh Harper says she saw the baby Jesus.
Mummy, it happened again!
Okay now.
All dry.
When the lions come, I go in Mummy's bed. She strokes my hair and tells me something nice.
Once upon a time, there was a bird.
The thing she tells is about a magic bird. It comes when you are dreaming, and next day if you find a feather, you can make a wish. My mummy has lovely golden hair. The most especial reason my daddy fell in love with her was her hair. Her hair and her stories, he says.
Are you listening, chicken?
I'm thinking about feathers.
Because it's the middle of the night here.
At my new school, Mrs. Lynn says the imagination is very special. It can take you anywhere in the whole wild world. And Cayleigh Harper says, I would rather get in a Ford Escort convertible. And Mrs. Lynn says, that is not what I mean, Cayleigh Harper. I hope you're not chewing.
There. No more nightmares.
Will we go home soon?
Hey, it's the school holidays. See Daddy in the morning?
Yes.
I love you, Button.
My mummy and me is on holiday. It is a village with my new school and a post office and a man with a dog that has one eye. And in the windows the people have writing that says, bring back hunting. My mummy calls.
Oh, why don't you bring back hanging while you're at it?
So not much people come to see us. Mrs. Lyme in the post office says...
You here for long?
And my mummy says...
Not if we can help it.
Everything is old in the holiday house.
God's sake, shut!
The doors and the windows and the cupboards and the kitchen things. Old things don't work properly, so my mummy has to shout at them.
Come on. Work! Oh, you stupid, stupid kettle! No! Oh!
In this house, everything that is mummy's right. Is in boxes.
Where's a saucepan?
All the plates are wrapped and the spoons and the cups. It's like Christmas, except there's no surprises and no baby Jesus.
All I want is a saucepan!
The boxes have sad things inside. I don't know what, blood or guts or something. When Molly opens them, her nose goes red and there is a swim in her eyes.
A ruddy saucepan!
In the house where we live with Daddy, the door is red. It has a knocker that is a lion and a number that says 10.
Fern, I'm sorry, love. It's just a bit of a tricky day for Mummy.
You can come to my daddy's if you like.
Let's get you a biscuit. What shall we have? Oh, no biscuits.
God, this house is useless.
At Daddy's house, there's biscuits. In Mummy's holiday garden, there's not much nice things either. There's some pots with leaves I mustn't pick in a tree. That's all there is. The tree is as high as the sky. I would like to touch the snow-white clouds. I would sit and wait for the bird to send me a wishing feather.
Fern! Daddy'll be here in a minute.
Mummy is my daddy's wife, and my daddy is Mummy's husband.
Funny!
One night at the house with the red door, my daddy shouted and my mummy shouted, and I lay very still in my bed, and this is what I could hear.
Where is he?
Don't be stupid.
Is he here?
Of course he isn't.
Now what are you doing?
They're my plates. They're my best bloody plates, and I'll smash them if I bloody want to.
And I didn't like the shouting, so I closed my eyes very tight, and all the shouting was like lions roaring and sheep baa-baaing, and the blooding plates was guns firing, and it sounded like this. In the morning, my daddy took me in his arms, and he said it wasn't me he was angry with.
I love you as far as the moon and back. No one can take away how much I love you.
Do you love my mummy as far as the moon and back?
Then my mummy came in and her eyes were all swimmy and she said,
Fern, I love you so much.
Do you love my daddy?
We're going on a little holiday, you and me.
And my daddy said,
You are the absolute ruddy limit!
Then my daddy left and the front door went smash. And no one was there, so my mummy cried. Sometimes when I can't sleep, I say to her it is because there are lions in my head. And she says, well, think of something not frightening. Think of rabbits. And they say, I did think of rabbits, but the lions ate them. And then she laughs and she says, go to sleep now, Fern. So that is when I think of her magic bird. I think of him carrying me on his back high, high into the sky. But I still hear the lions and the sheep and the guns.
Fern! Where are you? Fern, Dad is here! She's probably lost in a game. You know what she's like, head in the clouds.
She's very practical.
She isn't.
She is. With me, she is.
Fern!
Fernie! How's she doing at school?
Fine, settling in.
I rang.
The school?
Her teacher said she's not making friends.
You rang the school? What for?
She's my daughter.
Hello, Mummy. Hello, Daddy.
Hey, Tiger. What's she doing up a tree? Down you come.
Come here.
There we go.
I've packed her stuff for tomorrow with some spares.
How's Daddy's girl?
Lloyd.
Daddy missed you, yeah? What should we do this weekend?
She's been having bad dreams, you know, accidents.
Oh, she won't have nightmares. She's with me. Hey, Fernie, here comes the lion!
Listen.
Great big lion kisses for Fernie.
Lloyd, it's difficult. It's difficult to say things when you won't look at me.
Give us 1 minute, Fern. Okay? You play for 1 minute. Go on. All right, Lucy, what do you want to say?
I go round and round like a bird, and there is a ribbon in my beak, and I am wrapping it round and round their legs and their arms. It is wrapping them closer and closer, and soon they won't be able to walk away. They will have to stay standing together with their little bird.
I just want to... Oh, God, I don't know. I just want to say I'm sorry.
You're sorry?
Yes. For all the pain, I'm sorry. I didn't know how hard it would be. For you, for me, for Fern, I didn't know.
Hanky?
Oh, God! Even your hanky's making me cry now.
Do you still see him?
Of course not.
Do you want to come back? We could buy a new place in the country if you like, not like this. This place is falling apart. Somewhere nice, Luce. With an Argo thing. You and me and Fernie. I'd forgive you.
You'd do what?
For what you did.
Coo!
Fern! Fern, please stop whizzing round my legs. I can't think. You think all this is just because of me?
Excuse me, I didn't sleep with my friend's husband.
I didn't have a baby and bury my head in work.
If you have a five-bedroom house, someone has to pay the mortgage.
I didn't want five bedrooms. I wanted someone to talk to me. Lloyd!
Right. Fernie, who's coming with Daddy?
Mummy is your wife, isn't she, Daddy?
Yes, darling.
You're Mummy's husband, aren't you, Daddy?
In the car now.
Lloyd, you forgot the bag.
My boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you.
In the house with the red door, it was Mummy and Daddy and Fern, and we played in the garden. And Daddy carried Fern on his back and Mummy said,
Lloyd, come here.
And then she put her head on my Daddy's shoulder and she closed her eyes and she said,
my lovely man.
Whee, look at me!
Who wants more hula hoops?
I do.
You? Who's you?
Daddy's girl. I like houses with red doors best. At my Daddy's other house, the door doesn't have a lion and it doesn't have a number 10. It has a number 33 and it is black. At Daddy's new house, we can do what we like. We can eat biscuits on the settee and we can watch CBeebies till I fall asleep. Sometimes my Daddy says,
this is good, isn't it, Fern?
And sometimes he says,
has Mummy got any friends?
And sometimes the phone rings but we don't answer.
Hello? Hi, it's me. It's Lucy. Just, you know, phoning to check you arrived, OK? No need to phone back, just hello. And good night.
OK, Tiger?
Yep.
Aren't we having a good time, huh? Why would she ring if she didn't still love us?
Where did your long hair go? Where is the girl I used to know? How could you lose that happy glow? Oh, Carolina, who took that look away?
When grown-ups are sad, they listen to music that is about where are you and I am so hurty. If I was sad, I would listen to music that was about here I am and here is the sky and then I would feel better. At least the nice thing about sad music is that you can go to sleep.
For a long time, Mummy and me, we loved each other. Once we saw this old couple and they were sitting by a lake, maybe feeding ducks, I don't know. They were laughing, like kids. And I said, that's how we'll be one day. We've got it all to come. Yes, she said. She said yes. See, that's what I don't understand, Fern. She said yes that day with the old couple and the ducks. How come things got different? Where did all that love go when we weren't looking? You're all that's left.
Before I was born, I was a tiny seed, and my mummy loved my daddy, and my daddy loved my mummy, and their love was what made me. Cayleigh Harper says before she was born, she was a twinkle in her daddy's eye. And Mrs. Lynn makes a face like she has climbed a lot of stairs and she says, yes, Cayleigh, I expect you were. But Cayleigh Harper's dad wears glasses. Then, when I was a baby, I cried. And then when I was bigger, I said,
"Look at me! Look at me!"
And my mummy cried and my daddy shouted,
"Now what are you doing?"
"They're my best bloody plates and I'll smash them if I bloody want to."
And the blooding plates went smashing. And the lions and the sheep and the guns made too much shouting.
Daddy, it happened again!
There. All dry?
Oh, right. What should we do next?
We could have a biscuit.
Great! Hey, only 6 more hours till we see Grandma.
Daddy?
Yes, Fern?
I want my mummy.
So do I. Oh, Fern, I wish to God all this mess had never happened.
And that is when I have my most spectacular idea.
This one, Fern? This one, you mean?
The little one?
Whoa!
Lloyd, what are you doing?
Hi, Mum. Just fetching something. Fetching something for Fernie. She says it's important.
Hello, darling.
Kiss Grandma, Fern.
Hello, Grandma.
Oh, you shouldn't give her that, Lloyd. God knows where it's been.
On a duck. It's a feather. Here you go, Tiger.
Thank you, Daddy.
You look terrible.
Yes, Mum. Nice to see you too.
How did it work with that cleaner I found you?
Yeah, okay.
Whee, I'm a bird!
Get a girlfriend. That'll show Lucy. I know women talk about wanting men to see their feminine sides, but no one wants a man who's helpless. Is she still sleeping with your friend?
Here comes the little bird!
See, I don't understand. I thought marriage was for life. In my day, it was for life.
In your day, you had affairs.
I don't know what it is with your generation. You seem to believe there is such a thing as absolute happiness. You seem to think it's your right.
Whee!
Fight her over the house. Fight her over the money.
Whee!
But stop there.
Fern. Hello, my darling girl. Oh, Mummy missed you. Give me a squeeze.
Bye, Tiger. Daddy loves you so much.
I wish, I wish, I wish.
How's she been?
She's been great.
I wish, I wish, I wish.
I missed your call.
I was drunk.
On your own, or did you find a friend? Fern, are you going to open your eyes? Say goodbye to Daddy.
I wish, I wish, I wish.
Come on, Fern. It's time to come with Mummy.
I wish my dream come true. I wish the same for you.
So, how was it at Daddy's new house? What did you do?
I can't remember. Have you got some bread?
Oh, love. Did your daddy not feed you?
Come on, birds, lovely bread, come to Fern.
If your wish doesn't work the first time, you just have to do it again, only bigger. And if it's a big wish, you need more than one feather. You need stacks. Hundreds and thousands and tens and trillions and billions and infinity feathers.
Night, sweetheart.
Night, Mummy.
What are you hiding in your hand? A feather?
I wish I had my milk. Mummy?
Get some sleep, you.
Has anything happened?
When?
Now?
No.
Oh.
Oops, nearly forgot. I brought your milk.
Yes. Mrs. Lynn says when we don't know something, the answers are really inside us, and we just have to be still a minute and listen. And sometimes I think she is wrong, because when she says, "Fern, what is 4 times 4? I look inside me, but inside me it is shouting 26, or maybe not even numbers. Maybe it's just going lions again. But today I understand what Mrs. Lynn means, and I understand what I have to do next.
I found her out on the lane. I mean, I know it's a quiet village, but you should be more careful. She said she was collecting feathers.
Come on, Fern.
Say goodbye to the man.
Name's Flynn. You're new, aren't you?
We're just on holiday till I find somewhere else.
Well, if something needs fixing, give me a ring.
Nothing's broken.
Here, missus. A goose feather. Add it to your collection.
Goodbye. The next day I'm sitting up the tree and I see the man called Flynn again. And I shout out to say hello.
Who's that?
Up here.
Hey, I hope you're not trying to catch birds up there, missus.
Have you got any more feathers for me?
Well, maybe there'll be one on the ground if I have a look. I don't want to upset your mummy.
She cries quite a lot, actually. Boxes make her sad.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. You know, it's not easy bringing up kids on your own. And these days you've got to be careful. There's a lot of strange people about.
Do you know Cayleigh Harper at my new school? Because she is very strange. She wears crop tops and she has Heelys.
Well, different is not the same as strange.
Can you wink?
I can, actually.
I can as well. See?
Whoa, that is the best winking I have ever seen.
I have a daddy whose name is called Lloyd, and my mummy's name is called Lucy. At home, our house is a door that's red. This is just our holiday.
So how come you're collecting feathers? Do you like them?
Flynn is so nice, I'm nearly going to tell him my whole secret when the front door opens. And my mummy is standing by the door and I think she is going to shout, but instead she says...
You again? I suppose I'd better offer you a cup of tea. You'll have to excuse the mess. And my husband's got the teapot. Earl Grey or normal?
Normal's fine. So is Earl Grey.
Oh, it'll have to be coffee.
Well, that's fine too.
I've been here 3 months and I still haven't unpacked.
Well, you never know.
Don't you?
Here, Fern.
Is that feather for me?
It's from the wing of a barn owl. Now, if you look really carefully, there's a split at the tip. Do you see?
Why?
Ah, good question. And it stops the sound of the wind as the owl flies, so the owl can swoop down to catch a mouse and no one will hear, most especially the mouse. Clever, eh? It's all to do with aerodynamics.
What's aerodynamics?
Big stuff. Shall I put the kettle on?
Oh, don't touch the...
Whoa!
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's not the first thing to blow up in my hands.
You can stay for lunch, if you like. A scrambled egg, nothing much.
A scrambled egg would be nice.
Don't do that, Fern.
It turns out that the egg is not very nice, because my mummy does a thing she has not done before. She goes to the garden with my scissors, and when she comes back, she is smiling. Then she cooks grass with the eggs. But Flynn doesn't say it's horrible. He says...
Chives. Delicious.
I grew them myself, in a pot. It's the first thing I've ever grown in my life. Well, apart from bacteria.
And Flynn laughs. Then he winks at me and he says...
I'll tell you what, Fern. After lunch, why don't we take your mum hunting for feathers? I know all the best places.
It turns out the Flynn is an ornithologist. This is a way of saying he likes birds, but sometimes adults use big words because it shows they are good at things. And my mummy isn't sad. She helps us and she says...
Fresh air. This is what it smells like.
Flynn tells us all about the feathers. He shows us all the different shapes and colours.
The thing about feathers, Fern, is that they're like people.
Yes.
They're all different and they do different things.
Mm-hmm.
Some keep the bird warm and some protect him from the sunlight. And the big strong ones, they help the bird to fly.
Yeah.
Then there are feathers which help a bird to hide and some really nice ones which are just meant for helping him to find a wife. A bit like putting on your best jacket.
Your jacket is not very nice.
No.
It's got holes.
It has.
Fern.
My daddy has a blue jacket.
Oh. My daughter calls me a boffin.
Oh, you're married. I mean, of course.
My daughter's mother calls me a load of other things.
You're...
No, not married. Never was. Got a 20-year-old daughter, though. Hey, Fern! Have you ever been tickled with a feather?
No!
Here comes a tickling feather!
When we go home, the sky's pink and Flynn carries me on his shoulders because my legs and feet are out of puff. Yellow bird, you say...
sit all alone like me.
Fern says you're on holiday.
Yes, well, you know, just finding our feet.
This place must be quiet after London. You must miss your friends.
What friends? When you sleep with someone you shouldn't, albeit in a drunken stupor, your friends tend to desert you.
Oh.
Yes.
It takes two.
Well, you're the first person I've met who can see that. It's as if understanding why someone might wreck an apparently happy marriage will implicate them. As if, you know, don't have Lucy round for dinner, because she'll probably try and crawl into bed with your husband while you're fetching the filters for the coffee maker. Sorry. Have you ever noticed how all the songs are about the victims? It's not easy.
Do you know what I think?
No.
You still all right up there, missus?
Yes, I am, mister.
What do you think?
I think if love ever happens for me again, I will be kind. Does our friend know what's going on?
Our friend is six. What am I supposed to say?
Hey! Has anyone seen Fern?
Up here!
Where's Fern?
Oh, she's gone and flown away!
Here I am! Here I am!
Fern!
Where are you?
Fern! Fern!
Every day, Flynn takes me and Mummy looking for feathers. He tells me the feathers have different names, and that is contour feathers, and semi-plume, and down, and finner-plume, and bristles. Everything about a bird is made for flying.
All right, missus. How many feathers have you got?
I think I'll probably need some more, Flynn.
Flynn fixes the windows and the dodgy sockets, and my mummy starts to unpack the boxes.
Now then, let's get things sorted.
Lucy! Lucy, there's someone at your door!
Fern, there's someone at the door!
And then one day I open the door and this is Mrs. Lyon from the post office.
Hello, Fern. Little birdie tells me you're making a very special collection.
And she gives me a whole pillowcase, and it is full of tiny, curly white and grey feathers. So my mummy calls out,
Mrs. Lyon, please, come in, have a cup of tea.
And then there is another knock-knock.
Lucy?
Fern?
And it is Mr. Jasper, the butcher, and he says,
I was going to throw this out when I heard you were a collector.
And Mr. Jasper gives me a picture which is like a box, and underneath the glass there are lots of feathers, and they're the colour of jewels. And my mummy says,
Mr. Jasper, that's so kind. Please, have a cup of tea.
And the Lord knocks again, and then it knocks again, and it knocks again, and again, and again. And it is Mrs. Potter from next door.
Come in, come in.
And the man who has a one-eyed dog, and Mr. Wright who rides a bicycle. And the house is filled with people bringing feathers for my very special collection.
Have a cup of tea.
And I look at my mummy, and she has put on a nice dress with flowers and pretty pink lipstick. And it is like before all over again, and I am happy because soon I will have so many feathers I can make the biggest wish.
Are you all right, missus?
Yes, mister. And maybe when you live in the house with the red door, Flynn will come to tea. Hello?
So, how's my tiger? Tell Daddy you love me.
I love you, Daddy.
What's that noise, Fern? Is someone there?
Actually, please, can I go now?
Before we came here, I didn't think I'd ever be happy again. I thought in doing what I did, I'd relinquish the right. I'm happy today.
God, Fern's a great kid. Look,
Yes?
I was thinking this weekend we could go to the beach, take a picnic, maybe. We might see some cormorants.
Oh, no, the weekend's no good. She's with Lloyd. She's with her dad.
Oh.
Another time.
Yeah, yeah.
Unless...
Yeah?
I mean, it'd just be me.
Yeah?
You're probably busy.
No, not really.
But you could, you know, come for something to eat, if you wanted, that is... I could cook.
Yeah, that'd be great.
I mean, I cook badly.
I dress badly.
Good.
Good. See you Saturday.
Okay.
I wish.
These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. Yeah, one of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you.
Yeah, that's right. Come on. Who wants what, sis, hey?
Me.
How's Mummy? She's wearing lipstick. You all right, Fernie?
When we get to my daddy's house, there is a nice lady. She has lovely brown hair, but when she sees me, she says,
"Oh, my God!"
And when my daddy sees her, he says,
"Oh, my God! What are you doing?"
"I have a slip, babe."
And then he puts his coat on her and he says,
"Fernie, this is Sam. Say hello."
"Hello. Are you the lady who is my daddy's cleaner?"
"Am I?"
"Yep."
"I am."
"I like your nail varnish."
"Oh, thank you."
"I like your brown hair."
"Thank you."
"Where is your trousers?"
And my daddy says,
"Sam loves children, don't you, Sam?"
"Where are you? Come here! Come here!"
And we play this game, me and daddy and Sam. We play this game where I'm a little bird and they are chasing me. Only when they find me, they don't eat me, they just tickle. And then Daddy is tickling Sam, and Sam is laughing, and Daddy is laughing. And we are all happy except Mummy is not there. And the tickling is not like tickling anymore, it's actually more like poking. But we are still laughing. And I shout,
"Hello, Flynn!"
Flynn? Who's Flynn?
I don't know.
Is Flynn Mummy's friend?
I can't remember.
Lloyd?
Shut up. Does Flynn hug Mummy?
I've got a tummy ache in my head.
This guy's probably just a neighbour.
Would you keep out of this?
The lady called Sam who loves children puts her shoes on. She says,
"I'll let myself out, Lloyd."
You do that.
Have you ever thought what happens when two people pull hard on something?
Daddy?
Yes, Fernie?
What is aerodynamics?
Let me explain something.
So now there's somebody new. All falling through. You say I'll be fine. It only takes time. Someday that may be true. But it's too soon to tell.
My mummy is my mummy and my daddy is my daddy. And mummy loves Fern and daddy loves Fern. And even when I can't see them, my daddy is my daddy and my mummy is my mummy. And no one else is my daddy and no one else is my mummy. My mummy is my daddy. No, my mummy is my...
Not because you're dirty, not because you're clean. My mummy says you're the fairy queen.
Does she have to keep singing that?
Apparently a girl called Cayleigh Harper does it at school.
Cayleigh Harper can spit up walls.
And people question the merits of private education. Right, what are we here for?
Feathers.
She got a bit upset in the night. She says she needs them.
And what is wrong with the birds outside?
Any idiot can get those. I want to buy her ostrich feathers and peacock feathers and letter-spotted bloody woodpecker feathers. I want her to have the best feathers that any money in the world can buy.
I wish she could do some decent clothes while we're here. Does Mummy not know about hairbrushes anymore?
I think Lucy has other things on her mind.
Ah, oh, I see.
When I think of him eating breakfast with my daughter, I'd give anything to be him.
Lloyd, I know you're in torment and it absolutely breaks my heart. When your father died, I felt the same, but yeah, it gets easier. I mean, it just does. Time will weave its whatever it is.
It's magic.
Exactly. Thank you, Fern.
Today is the day.
All right, I'll wait in the car if you really want to go and fetch your feathers. Just be quick, though. I need to get home. I love you, Tiger. Up to the moon and back.
Hello, Button. Flynn's here. He found you a cormorant feather.
Daddy bought me one.
Hello, missus. Is that your dad parked outside?
I wish so hard it hurts my eyes. I think of the red door of my mummy and daddy.
I wish.
And then it begins to go wrong. I hear all the wrong things. I hear the lions and the sheep and the guns. And what is 4 times 4?
4 fours are 16.
And I see Flynn.
All right, missus.
And the nice lady called Sam.
Hello, Fern. I love children.
And Mrs. Lime is knocking on the door.
Who likes feathers?
And I'm shouting, no, no, but no one is listening and they are all coming inside. So in my head I run into the garden and climb my special tree. And I am a little bird and everyone is saying, what a lovely bird. I want the bird. And they are climbing up the tree and they are pulling on my wings and my claws and my beak and they are saying,
I love you.
And it hurts and I have a tummy ache and I think I will just split.
I love you.
I wish.
And when I open my eyes, I put the feathers down and go downstairs to see if my wishing has worked. But no one is there. It's just me.
Fern? I bought you a cup of juice. Do you want it?
No. No, thank you. Juice is bad for my teeth.
Fern, I know it's tough.
You're not my daddy.
No. I'm an extra person to love you.
What colour is your door?
It's blue. Yeah, blue.
Mine is red.
Shall we go for a walk, look for some feathers?
Actually, I've grown out of feathers.
Sure. Well, you let me know if you change your mind.
I take my feathers and I shake them out of the window. And they are like a cloud of snow in the air. And then they are gone. That night, I can't sleep. I get up and go creepy, creepy downstairs.
Lucy, you've got to tell her.
Tell her what? She's sick.
Oh, crying out loud. She still thinks you're on holiday. Are you staying? Because I, for one, would like to know.
The divorce papers came through.
And?
I signed them.
Do you want me to...
What?
I don't know. Go?
No. It's just... How do you say to a 6-year-old? How do you say... Me and Daddy, we were really happy once. And then, I don't know, we started not to be happy. We started to tear bits and bits and bits off what we had, and in the end we had nothing. So one of us had to put an end to it. How do you say that?
Like that, I guess.
What's that?
What?
That noise. Fern? You think I'm an idiot?
Don't.
It's easy for you. You've got your teenage daughter and your ex-partner and everyone has tea and cake while the rest of us struggle just to be half decent.
Me? Well, you've got me down as decent. 20 years ago, I had a girlfriend. Out of the blue, she gets pregnant. And we're married. Now, we're 16 and we're going to be parents. We'll get ourselves a house in, a job for me down at the builder's yard, and all through the pregnancy, it's great. I read all the books. I make our own cot. Then the baby's born, and guess what?
What?
I don't like it. You know, the crying, the need, the routine. I can't handle it. So I walk out and she never hears from me again. And 15 years later, I get a letter from my daughter and she's beautiful. And I'm so guilty. I'm so messed up about what I've done that I run away again. And she traces me again and she says to me, she says, Dad, you're not perfect, but you're my dad. I mean, how sorted is that?
Oh, here, come here.
You know, you have to pass a test to drive a car, but when it comes to kids, we're free falling. Well, please, just tell Fern the truth, eh?
Hello, Mummy.
Fern.
Hello, Mister.
Hello.
Shall we have a biscuit?
Flyn comes to stay in with me and Mummy, and it isn't a holiday anymore. It's our home and it doesn't have lions. Daddy's house is home too, except it isn't home for Mummy and Flyn, or the nice lady called Sam. Feathers work because they help lift the bird up in the sky. And the air on top of the bird is pushing, and the air under the bird is pushing. But the air on top is not as big as the air that is under, so the bird can fly. It's not magic. That's when you don't know how something works, so you call it magic, but actually, it's aerodynamics. And God is a bit like magic, but I don't say that to Mrs. Lynde.
Fern! There's someone here to see you!
Hello, Fern.
Hello, Cayleigh.
Do you still collect feathers?
I don't know.
Do you want to see what I got? See? It's a baby one. It came out of the sky. Do you want to touch it?
That's called down.
Is it?
Yeah.
Down, down, down.
Did your dad bring you?
No, my stepdad. My dad lives in a different house.
Yeah, mine too. Cayleigh?
Yeah, Fern?
If you like, I could show you some more feathers. I know all the best places.
Yes, please, Fern.
Do you know this joke?
What joke?
What do you call two robbers?
I don't know, Fern. What do you call two robbers?
A pair of knickers.
A pair of knickers?
Feelings can go away. Little girl, you are here to stay.
In Feather by Rachel Joyce, Fern was played by Maisie Cowell, Lucy by Claire Price, and Flynn by Shaun Dooley. Lloyd was played by Jot Davies, Margot by Richenda Carey, Sam, Rachel Bavidge, and Cayleigh, Morgan Gayle. The director was Tracey Neale.